your Cleveland Browns.
Welcome to this exhibition clash between the Browns and the Steelers.
And Chris, we can't help but mention rivalry in this one.
Gus, no one will argue that Pittsburgh and Cleveland practically define what a rivalry is. Not only have they met more times than any other AFC teams have, but they have bloodied and bullied each other beyond belief. We should be in store for a great game.
All right, Chris, with that in mind, it's game time, and we've got two teams really ready to rumble. Ryan has the ball all teed up, and he looks ready to get this game underway. This will be down to the end zone for a touchback.
And here comes Big Ben Roethlisberger out of Miami of Ohio.
The offense will take over at the 20. It's first and 10. Still looking for an open man. He's brought down around the 42-yard line by Rucker.
Now we have a first down and 10 to go.
Here's a pitch left side. They tackle him for a loss.
And let's take a look at some of the key players of this offensive unit who, as a group, hope to have a great game in this one. And Chrissy is definitely primed to be a performer to watch in this one.
Brings up second down and about 12 yards to go. Ball on their own 39. Surveys the field.
So with that, let's take a look at some of the members of this defensive unit, a group that is looking to make a name for themselves in this matchup.
Looking for a big gain down the middle. And the tackle was made by DeQuell Jackson. Everything seemed to work perfectly on that one.
And that was a nice job by the offensive line, allowing the quarterback enough time to survey the field and find the open guy.
They spot the rock on the 42-yard line.
Mendenhall takes the give. He lost yardage on the play.
There are just some guys in this league that you have to run away from. But the danger in that is you run away from him and he uses his speed to catch you from behind.
facing a second and 11. Ball on the 42. Dumps it out right. The stop was made by T.J. Ward. 6 yards that time on the pass play. So it's third down. The offense will need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Flips it out short to his left. And he's tackled around the 33-yard line by Rucker. And they'll line up for the long field goal try. This one from 50. And the kick is good. Joe Nedney kicks it through to break the tie. Pittsburgh will be kicking off. Cribbs is deep, looking to return the kickoff. Camps under it. He will start from his own 5. Arnaz Battle was there for the stop. So now the quarterback comes onto the field, and in conversations with him earlier in the week, he mentioned that he really wanted to get going early and get into a rhythm. Let's see if he can do just that. The offense will start at the 19-yard line. First down and 10. Hillis gets the carry.
And let's spotlight the offensive key players. Running back Peyton Hillis out of Arkansas has become a sensation, grinding out those tough yards between the tackles.
And it doesn't always have to be pretty to be effective, and Peyton Hillis is one of the hardest working running backs in the league. You know, not only is he so tough to bring down, but he has acceleration into the hole, and that is really underrated.
And Chrissy is definitely primed to be a performer to watch in this one. Defense is the recipe for success for this team, and they've enjoyed a lot of it. Of course, it all starts with exceptional strong safety, the Tasmanian Devil, Troy Polamalu out of USC.
Yeah, I don't know what more you can say about Troy Polamalu that hasn't been said 100 times. He's just one of the best, and maybe one of the best ever, and he's probably ticketed for the Hall of Fame. I know that is high praise, but when you watch him play, he can just do so much, and his instincts seem to always take him to the ball.
And when you get a wide receiver with that kind of talent on the outside, he is a threat to take it all the way on any play.
They line up at the 48. McCoy hands it off. Lawrence Timmons was there to bring him down. It's second down and 8 to go. Ball is on the 47. Here comes the heat.
The quarterback had no chance on that play. Talk about raw determination by the defender to get into the backfield.
Yeah, not a lot of pretense on that play, huh? He is so strong, it seems like he can bulldoze through these huge offensive linemen almost at will. They're going to need to find a way to double-team him if they ever hope to keep him off their quarterback.
And that opens up room for other defenders.
Yeah, exactly, and that's another reason why he's so dangerous. You need 2 guys to shut him down, which allows one of the other defenders to get after the quarterback unblocked.
Dumps it out left.
Quarterback that time wasn't going to do anything to negatively impact his quarterback rating. Didn't want to take a chance at throwing an interception down the field, just dumped it off. Let's bring on the punt.
And they already have the lead. This field position could set them up to put even more points on the board. They'll set up shop at the 20-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Inside give. He's wrestled down around the 21-yard line by Gokhan. Second down, 8 yards to go. Looking to his left. He's going deep. Right through his hands. He almost had the pick. Brown was the intended receiver. So, it is 3rd and 8. Has a man short to his left. So, the offense will probably head off the field after failing to convert for a first down on that series.
Well, and there is some cumulative effect of those 3-and-out series because they do tend to wear out your defense, which has to come right back out on the field now.
Cribs will start running at the 39.
Man, those guys were flying down the field. He didn't have a chance on that one. His blocker's got to do something for that poor guy out there, or he's going to get killed.
They'll take over at the 40. And we'll have a first down and 10. McCoy flips it out. He's tackled around the 41-yard line by Foot. We've played a quarter. The score is 3-0. Steelers. That'll make it second down with 10 to go. Fires a strike to the right. The defender tips it away.
Whoa, that was really lucky that one wasn't picked off. Not a good decision at all there.
It's 3rd down, 10 yards for first. Ball on their own 41. Looking for a man. And the tackle was made by James Harrison. It's 4th down. The Browns line up to punt. And it's in the end zone for a touchback. They'll get the ball here at the 20. It's 1st and 10. Searching for an open man. He's loose and running strong.
Who says quarterbacks aren't athletes? He looked pretty good on that play. Nice job, found the hole, got upfield, got down without getting injured. Good play.
From their own 33-yard line. Looks for the safe short throw.
Boy, the quarterback has to be a better decision maker than that. There's no way he was going to get that one in.
So they'll face a 2nd and 10. He rolls out to the right. Short pass to his left. The stop was made by Sheldon Brown. 6-yard gain on the play. J. just about 4 yards shy of the first here on third down. Takes a lick as he lets it go.
And even though that one doesn't go down as a sack, that's one of those that the quarterback remembers and probably rushes him just a little bit on the next throw.
He takes the ball at the 20. Monroe was there for the stop.
Man, those guys were flying down the field. He didn't have a chance on that one. His blocker's got to do something for that poor guy out there, or he's going to get killed.
They'll start at the 24-yard line. Now we have a first down and 10 to go. Hillis gets the ball. He's dropped down at about the 27 by Kissel. They're looking at a second and 7. He'll be brought down behind the line of scrimmage.
The Browns are simply getting stuffed on nearly every rushing attempt. They need to get a spark somehow because this just does not bode well for them.
Facing a 3rd and 8 situation. The ball is on their own 26. Good coverage downfield. Has a man out to his right. And the tackle was made by Troy Polamalu. That's a first down right there. Might want to play them a little tighter. Maybe even go to the man coverage.
Yeah, it's pretty tough to play a zone coverage against this quarterback. He does a great job in recognition, and that time you could see him move the zone defense just a little with his eyes before he threw it in there.
From their own 46-yard line. McCoy with the draw play.
And when your defensive line can handle their guys up front and not allow the offensive lineman to get down on the linebackers, it really gives those linebackers a chance to look great.
So it's 2nd down, 14 yards for the first. Ball on their own 42. He's searching for a receiver. He needs to get rid of it. He's going to run with it. Lawrence Timmons was there to bring him down. Third and short situation now. They'll need a couple of yards to convert. Goes through his progression. Passes short right side. He's brought down around the 37-yard line by McFadden. They line up at the 37. On the ground with the tailback. The stop was made by Lamar Woodley. It's a gain of 4. It's 2nd down and 6. Hillis gets the carry left side. He hasn't had a good first half at all. Just can't seem to get through this defense. The defense is really struggling on 3rd down on this drive. The offense has already converted on this drive alone. Still looking for an open man. A burst of speed, and he's in the open.
Is this a first down? Well, here comes the measurement. He came up short, and it's fourth down now.
They were so close to keeping this drive alive. I don't know. I think in this situation, you go for it.
Looks like they're going for it here on fourth down. Here's the give. The Tasmanian Devil, Troy Polamalu, was there for the stop. First down and 10. Hillis takes a handoff.
Yeah, you can draw up any sort of protection scheme and blocking scheme that you want, but ultimately this game comes down to one big man against another big man, and that time the defense's big men, they won the battle.
Second down, 11 yards for first. Surveys the field. Wants the end zone! Tarver was his intended target. Third down. Third down now. They'll need 11 to move the chains. Ball on the 21-yard line. Looking for a man. Throws to his right. Intercepted.
You might want to start thinking about trying to pick on that guy. We've seen all day he has simply been quicker to the spot than the wide receivers coming into his area.
First down, 10 to go. Flips it out short. Fires into a crowd. Interception. And he's tackled right around the 20-yard line by Wallace. And we'll have a first down and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. Looking, fires it to the left. He cruises in for the touchdown.
Well, it just goes to show that you don't have to be the fastest guy on the football field to get open. That time, some physical play, getting off the line of scrimmage, a good quick cut, and he gets it in for the touchdown.
Dawson is good on the point after. Cleveland holds a 4-point lead. Cleveland is just about ready to kick this one away. Brown stands back to field the kick. Young was there to bring him down.
The quarterback found his man there and picks up a big gain through the air. Chris, how did he get open on that play?
Well, Gus, this guy is known for being a ball hawk, but sometimes if a defensive back tries to make a play on the ball, he'll come up short and leave his receiver open for a big gain, and I think that's exactly what we saw there.
It'll be interesting to see how he plays him for the rest of the game.
He picks it up to the 10. Touchdown, Cleveland.
And just like that, they make it a two-possession game.
What a tremendous return that was. And even better, now you have a little breathing room when you look up at that scoreboard.
Dawson tacks on the extra point. Cleveland is ready to kick this one off. Wallace is deep, looking to return the kickoff. Well, let's see if the offense can make up for their misfortune from just a few moments ago. They'll go to work at the 19. It's first and 10. Here's a pass over the middle. Can't hang on. It's knocked loose. They'll face second down and 10. Flips it out short to his left. They'll get 9 yards on the play.
9 yards on the play.
Short yardage situation here. They'll need a little less than a yard to convert. They'll throw for the first. Sheldon Brown was there for the stop. Rashard Mendenhall makes his third catch of the game. Looks right, throws. Sanders was the intended receiver on the play. Searching for an open man. Goes for it all. He's got room. He's wrestled down at about the 33-yard line by Young. Good coverage downfield. All he needs is one hand.
Number 7. Complete.
Pass completed for a gain of 8.
Gain of 8 on the play.
Pittsburgh. The Steelers will take their last time out. It's up and it's good. So the score now, the Steelers, 6. The Browns, 14. You don't really want to kick it deep here and risk a return, so let's see if they kick it short to take us to halftime. It's fielded at the 2. He makes it to the 22. Allen was there to bring him down. McCoy tosses it left. Brought down behind the line. And we've come to halftime here. The score is 14-6.